This time I will discuss the storyline of the film entitled The Social Network. This is the true story of the founder of Facebook, Mark Zuckerberg. The storyline in this film is a bit confusing, guys. Maybe for those of you who are watching it for the first time will be confused because the storyline is a mixture of forward and backward. I, myself, have to watch it 3 times before I can understand the details, like in the middle of a movie, suddenly we are taken to the future and flashback to the past, and suddenly when we were in the past we were suddenly taken to jump back into the past. Front. But I have summarized for you the story of the film this time, only using one plot, namely the forward plot, so that it is easier for you to understand. And let's get straight to the story. At the beginning of the film, it is said that Mark Bermuda is still studying at Harvard and he is chatting at a cafe with his girlfriend, Erica Albright. Erica is a very simple and kind person. She wants to keep listening to Mark's conversation, which is actually confusing. Maybe other girls will think Mark is weird, but Erica is still loyal to accompany him. This Mark may be because his work is always in front of the laptop, so he doesn't know this is a good way of socializing. In the end all he talks about coding, programming, and things that are actually trivial, but this Mark is being taken seriously, and also this Mark's expression is really flat, guys. So people don't know if he's joking or serious. They come to a chat where Mark doesn't respect Erica. Well, here I'm not really clear about what Mark was talking about, but basically Erica was offended and they both broke up. Even when they broke up, Erica still respected Mark by not leaving immediately, but Erica accompanied Mark. Erica also says it's better to just be friends. Long story short, Mark is really hurt because after Erica dumped him he then ran back to his dorm at Harvard and he too then blocked or wrote on his blog and told all about Erica's ugliness in that blog, like her bra size was small and kept Erica whore and others. While drunk, Mark kept venting his pain in his blog posts. What I like about this Mark is that when he is annoyed or angry, his brain suddenly activates and he immediately gets brilliant ideas, guys. So Mark is not venting his emotions into anger but into new ideas. Maybe this can be an example for those of you who are currently confused. Mark suddenly got the idea to create a site called facemish.com, where facemish.com is a site to review every girl on campus based on her sexiness. Then suddenly, Mark's loyal friend, Eduardo, came. Eduardo came because after reading Mark's blog that he had been dumped by his girlfriend, Erica. And Eduardo's intention was to entertain Mark, but when Eduardo came, he was asked by Mark to help make his facemish.com. Eduardo initially hesitated because it could violate the law, because it could be a defamation of the girls and later would be hostile to all the girls on campus, but Eduardo finally wanted to help and Eduardo gave an algorithm to rank the girls. You can say that all of them are good at IT, guys, because they study at Harvard with a major in IT. Mark, Eduardo and his 2 roommates then started collecting photos of girls by hacking the campus site itself, namely Harvard. The point is that there will be 2 photos of girls. Then you will be asked to choose the girl on the left or the right who is sexier, more or less that's how it works. Then after the site was launched, that night, the site went viral, guys. The site got 2,200 visitors in just 2 hours. The whole campus was excited and the boys there were really fun picking out photos of every girl on the site. Then came where Erica, Mark's ex-girlfriend, was reading Mark's blog. And he finally cried reading Mark's writing that badmouthed him, and that night almost everyone made fun of Erica too. The other girls were also angry with Mark. Well, that site is considered to belittle them. Finally, after that night, Mark became enemies with all the girls on the Harvard campus. Mark was then summoned to the Harvard office for trial because he hacked the Harvard website. But at that trial Mark, instead of apologizing but instead being proud that he managed to hack a Harvard class site, Mark said that thanks to him now Harvard has come to know that their site is not safe, and Mark should get an award. In the end, Mark was sentenced to 6 months of probation, and if he did it again Mark would be expelled from campus. The news then reached Cameron, Taylor and Diva. namely three people who are working on a project to create an online site, a social media called Harvard Connection. Then the four of them chatted and shared with each other. Mark also told a story when he was in high school. He once made a music application and then the application was given to Microsoft for free. And the three of them explained to Mark about their idea, so that later Harvard Connection will become social media where if we create an account there we can fill in our interests, age, personal data, photos and invite friends online. Then the Mark said that it was no different with Friendster and MySpace. There's nothing original there, it just carries the name Harvard. But in the end Mark joined and wanted to help them do their project. But in the middle of the road Mark came out and had a new idea, guys. And want to create their own online social media site. Mark also approached Eduardo because he knew that Eduardo was quite rich, so Mark needed capital to carry out his idea. Mark explained and tried to convince Eduardo that back then Facemish.com was viral. It's viral, not because people just want to see and choose photos of girls. Because if you just want a photo of a girl, people can also look for it on other online sites. But what people like about the Facemish is that the photos of the girls on the Facemish are people they know. So Mark thinks that people actually want to know what activities people they know, like their boyfriends, friends and family are doing. So Mark wants to make social media where if we open the page of the person we know, we can see what he's doing right now. And social media is different from the previous Facemish which was illegal because it collected data by hacking or hacking other sites. This will no longer be necessary because people will fill in their own data on the page. Edward finally joined and helped Mark to supply his capital fund of $1,200. Eduardo will be the co-founder and Mark will be the CEO. And after 30 days of non-stop coding and marking for days without sleep, finally on the 11th of January 2004 a site called the Facebook was created. But after walking for about a month Mark is still not satisfied, guys. And felt that something was missing from his website. Mark thought about it for days until he didn't sleep. And finally, Mark's college friend came over to Mark and asked about a girl in Mark's class named Stephanie Zen. He asked if Stephanie Zen already had a boyfriend or was single, and if she was single, was she looking for a boyfriend or did she really not want to date? Hearing that, Mark was immediately shocked and Mark, who was dizzy, finally found what he felt was lacking. And that is, people don't walk in public wearing necklaces marked with boyfriends or singles. So from that, the Mark was inspired to provide it on the account page, namely the status selection column. So all the guys in this world who are in love with a girl then he can see the girl's Facebook page and see if she is single or already has a boyfriend. And after all that, Mark finally felt that all the components on the site on Facebook were perfect. And after days of not sleeping, finally the Facebook site was successfully released and officially launched. And the Mark finally fell asleep sitting up. Long story short, the Facebook site went viral and almost everyone at Harvard used it. It's so famous that there's a new slang, guys, that's my Facebook. In the past, people who just met said my SMS or my email. Well now people are saying that's my Facebook. So there's a new language here. And Mark and Eduardo also became famous, and every time on the road or at an event there was always someone who greeted the two of them, and said that they were fans. And there are two girls who are very aggressive, and are so big fans of girls that they force them both to go to the toilet to have sex. Okay. Then at a restaurant Mark accidentally saw his ex-girlfriend, Erica and Mark greeted him to apologize for what he wrote on a blog that had badmouthed him. But Erica was already really hurt and didn't want to see Mark's face again. No matter how famous Mark is now Erica doesn't care anymore. Mark finally went home full of regret. Then, in Mark and Eduardo's dorm room, they both got into an argument, because Eduardo saw a lawsuit, suing the Facebook for stealing the idea for Cameron Taylor and Diver's plan for the Harvard Connection site that Mark had joined before, and left halfway. the three of them felt that the Facebook concept or the main idea had been stolen from their Harvard connection idea. So, Eduardo explained that as a friend, Mark should always let him know if there was a problem. Because Eduardo will always be there to help Mark in every problem he faces. I'm honest, guys, the actor I like the most right now is Andrew Garfield, guys. From the start of Spider-Man and Hacksaw Ridge, I watched the movie. All of his acting characters are really good. When he talks and acts, it seems like he can really do that, if his acting talent is different, guys. Okay, let's continue. The demands from Cameron Taylor and Diva are still ongoing. But we'll talk about that at the end. Now Mark and Eduardo are accompanied by Eduardo's girlfriend, Christy, again meeting Sun Parker. Sun Parker is the owner of Naps.com, a pirated music download site, and you could say he is a billionaire from his online site. Although Sun Parker is currently bankrupt, and Sun Parker is planning to collaborate with Mark to develop the Facebook. But this Eduardo doesn't like this Sun Parker because of his goofy style. From arriving half an hour late, likes to play with girls, and to having been hit by drugs. After all the conversation was over and Sun Parker was about to leave, he said to Eduardo and Mark that the word "the" should be removed. Just use Facebook.com. And meanwhile Mark and Eduardo changed the name of their site to Facebook.com. Long story short, Sun Parker's journey always instigated Mark in a bad direction, guys. Like always inviting parties, teaching girls how to play and until the climax, this Sun Parker instigated Mark to kick Eduardo out of the team. But Mark still thinks twice about kicking Eduardo. Then with all the relationships that Sun Parker has, this Sun Parker helped develop Facebook. Which was previously only on one server, namely the American server, so it can be used on all servers in the world. And finally after the struggle Mark and Eduardo have been pioneering Facebook from scratch. They both finally got their first big investment, which amounted to $500,000, and Mark finally got a new, better Facebook office. But Mark ended up being instigated by Sun Parker. And Mark finally kicked Eduardo out of the team. And when Eduardo found out that his name had been crossed out and he was framed, Eduardo was angry and disappointed with Mark. Eduardo didn't think that he was betrayed by his best friend. Eduardo didn't think that Mark would prefer Sun Parker, just because he has a big relationship to develop Facebook, rather than his own friend who started Facebook together from the start. And Eduardo finally left the Facebook office. And after Facebook was successful and reached its first 1,000,000 users. And everyone in the office is celebrating his achievement, Mark feels like something is missing, guys, since Eduardo left. He feels unhappy that his dream has been successful and has come true. It was late in the evening when everyone was having a 1,000,000 user celebration party. But the Mark did not come to the party, he still chose to stay in the office. And while at the party, Sun Parker, who was having a drug party, was suddenly raided by the police, and finally he was caught by the police. Sun Parker called Mark to ask for help. Mark apparently didn't want to help and instead kicked Sun Parker to leave the team too. It turns out that the one who called the police to raid the drug party, Sun Parker, turned out to be Mark himself, guys. Finally, Mark is now left alone at the top of Facebook's position as CEO. On Mark's journey to the top, he has sacrificed a lot of things, guys. Starting from his ex-girlfriend, Erica, the three originators of the initial idea of social media, namely Cameron, Taylor and Diva, the Sun Parker, and of course he has also sacrificed his own best friend, Eduardo. At the end of the film, it is told that Mark Zuckerberg is facing lawsuit after lawsuit from Cameron, Taylor and Diva about the theft of their idea. And also a lawsuit from Edward, his best friend. But in the end they all reached a peace agreement. And decided to no longer pursue their lawsuit. After all that was done, Mark Zuckerberg then opened his Facebook and opened Erica's Facebook page and he invited her as a friend. Mark, who has not been able to move on until now, kept on refreshing his browser to see if his friend invitation was accepted or not, and the film ended. we can take lessons from this film. That true friends do not see wealth, caste, religion, shortcomings or advantages. Friends are not about who you have known for a long time, but about who came into your life and never left you in any bad situation or condition. Thank you for watching this discussion. Don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel, so that this channel continues to grow. Until tomorrow.